Hi friends, in this video we are going to see a problem based on OCSC test of a single phase transformer. Here we are going to do two things. One, we are going to obtain equivalent circuit of a transformer, and secondly we are going to calculate efficiency of a transformer at one particular load. So here is the problem. A 5 kVA 400/200 volt 50 hertz single phase transformer gave the following results during open and short circuit test. OC test 400 volt 1 ampere 60 watt, and it is performed on HV side. SC test 15 volt 12.5 ampere 50 watt. The test is performed again on HV side only. We have to calculate no load parameters R0 and X0, equivalent resistance and reactance referred to high voltage side, iron and copper losses at full load, and efficiency at half load and 0.8 power factor lagging. So let's start. First, I will take the test result of open circuit test. So for OC test, we got V0 400 volt, I0 1 ampere, and W0 is nothing but iron loss WI equal to 60 watt. WI is nothing but V0 I0 cos phi 0. So it's a 60 equal to 400 multiplied by 1 multiplied by cos phi 0. So from this I can get cos phi 0 equal to 0.15, and cos inverse if I take, I will get phi 0 81.37 degree. From the phi 0 I can get sin phi 0, which is nothing but 0.9887. We know no load primary current I0 has two components. One is IC, that is given by I0 cos phi 0, which is nothing but core loss component of no load primary current, and that is passing through RC. So this will give you answer 1 multiplied by 0.15, nothing but 0.15 ampere. Similarly, I mu is the magnetizing component of no load primary current given by I0 sin phi 0 equal to 1 multiplied by 0.9887 equal to 0.9887 ampere. Now, IC is flowing through RC, where V0 is the voltage applied across that parallel branch where RC and XM is connected. So I can get RC nothing but no load resistance of the transformer equal to V0 by IC. So V0 is 400 and IC is 0.15. So if you solve, you will get RC equal to 2666.6667 ohm. Similarly, I can get XM, magnetizing reactance, same as X0 equal to V0 upon I mu. So it is equal to 400 divided by 0.9887. So if you solve, you will get XM or X0 equal to 404.5717 ohm. So we got no load parameters. Let's proceed further. Now I will take results of short circuit test. I will get VSC as 15, ISC 12.5 ampere, and WSC equal to 50 watt. Short circuit test, that power given is a copper loss. And what resistor we have to take, it depends where the test is performed. So once again, I'll go back to the problem statement. So in the problem statement, they are saying the test is performed on HV side. So if you check here, this will be our HV side, nothing but a primary. So I have to take a resistance referred to primary. So that will be equal to R1E. So WSC is 50, ISC is 12.5. So solving this, I will get R1E equal to 0.32 ohm. Now Z1E, impedance referred to primary side, is VSC upon ISC, 15 upon 12.5. The answer you will get is 1.2 ohm. Z1E is nothing but root of R1E square plus X1E square. So it's 1.2 equal to root of 0.32 square plus X1E square. So the only unknown is X1E, and you will get X1E equal to 1.1565 ohm. Now we got four parameters of an equivalent circuit of a transformer. Whether we want to refer to other side, that idea you will get from where the tests are performed. So tests are performed on HV side, both the tests, and we want equivalent circuit referred to high voltage side. So luckily we are not supposed to refer parameters to other side, meaning I can get a equivalent circuit diagram simply like this. It will be like this: RC, XM, R1E, X1E, and this will be high voltage side. So high voltage side is 400. We got RC as 2.67 kilo ohm, XM 0.404 kilo ohm, R1E we got 0.32 ohm, and X1E is 1.1565 ohm. So this is the equivalent circuit diagram we are getting whenever we are referring to the high voltage side. Let's proceed further now for efficiency. So second part is calculating efficiency. For that purpose, I should know full load copper loss. So what they have given is this: WSC we are getting 50 watt when current ISC is 12.5 ampere. Now we are performing this test on high voltage side, and high voltage is the primary. So I can say this current is I1. So to get a full load copper loss, I should know I1FL. So how to get I1FL? It's very simple. It's a KVA 5000 divided by primary side voltage, which is a 400. So if you solve, you will get I1FL is 12.5 ampere. So WCUFL, nothing but WSC multiplied by I1FL upon I1 square. So WSC is 50, I1FL is 12.5, and I1 is also 12.5. So if you solve, you will get full load copper loss is nothing but 50 watt. Whatever power you are obtaining in an open circuit test, that is nothing but iron loss. W iron, or you can say iron loss, given as 60 watt. Now the formula of efficiency is X into KVA rating multiplied by power factor upon x into KVA rating multiplied by power factor plus iron loss plus x square WCU FL. Here all the values are known to us. They are saying half load, so x equal to 0.5, KVA rating is 5000, power factor is 0.8, iron loss is 60, x is 0.5, so it is a 0.5 square, WCUFL is 50. So if you solve this, you will get efficiency equal to 0.965. In percentage, it will be 96.5%. So efficiency equal to 0.5, KVA rating is 5000, power factor is 0.8 upon 0.5 into 5000 into 0.8, iron loss is 60 plus 0.5 square into full load copper loss is 50. If you solve, you will get answer efficiency equal to 0.965. In percentage, it will be 96.5%. That is the required answer. Thank you.